this is such a cool idea for a movie, but this movie, and you wouldn't get it from watching it, you would get it from, I guess, the costumes, but this is based on a 14th century piece of writing.
Yes. Yeah, it's an unconventional movie, but it's based on something that was created. So basically, it's based on this book called the Decameron, which was written in the 14th century, and at that time, these young women, they became nuns, not necessarily because they had strong religious beliefs, but it's just what you did, or you were forced into it. And so there was all these women in these convents who had desires to have sex and to party, but they kind of had to suppress everything. So our movie, I play a guy who gets in trouble. He's on the run. He comes across this convent, and he convinces them to let him hide out. And slowly over time, he starts hooking up with the nuns, and that is the movie I'm currently promoting.
Yeah. John C. Reilly, yeah, this is the movie for our times.
Yeah.
John C. Reilly in that clip, and tons of funny people in this movie. And one of the things, I heard there was not a script for this film.
Yeah. Yeah, so there was literally no script. It was all based on an 18-page outline, so it was completely improvised, which is terrifying. But like you said, it's like there's so many great comedic actors. It's John C. Reilly, Molly Shannon, Aubrey Plaza, Fred Armisen. The list never stops, and they make my job easy. They make me look a lot funnier than I naturally am, so that's the secret that I've been using. It's just continuing to surround myself with people who are better than me.
And yeah. Did you... by the way, I play the same game.
Yeah.
Did you then have to learn how to speak in 14th century speak, or did the director kind of let you say, like, hey, let's keep it modern?
I drew the line at that. I was not going to improvise in flowery, old-timey language. But no, it was still, like, not the easiest thing in the world.
your wife is in this film.
Yes.
Congratulations. The very funny, the very talented Alison Brie is in this film. And... She is one of these nuns who has these desires.
Correct.
But she is not one of the nuns that your character shares desires with.
Sometimes I share desires with her, but a lot of the time not. And so a lot of people have been asking, like, is that weird to have your wife on set while you're sharing desires with these other women? And the true answer is no, it's totally fine. It is what it is. We've both been doing this long enough to know that this is part of the job. It's a weird part of the job, but... Whatever. So that being said, there was a threesome scene that I'm in that she is not in.
Now that's even harder.
It sparked a little more conversation between us than usual.
Well, especially where it's like, I have a sex scene, and it's like, with who? And it's like, well, it's more than one person.
Yeah. So she decided she didn't want to be on set that day. And so I did the scene, and it was fine. And I went back to the hotel. She asked how it was. I said it was totally cool. And we left it at that. And cut to a year later, we're watching the movie for the first time together, and the threesome scene starts. And there was a moment that I had almost forgotten about, which involves the two girls, Aubrey Plaza and Jemima Kirk, sniffing my penis. Uh-huh. And
I always forget stuff like
that. Yeah. And so I kind of looked at her out of the corner of my eye, wondering what could possibly be going through her head. And the scene ended, and there was silence. And then she turned to me, and she said, "That was really sexy."
All right.
And that's the moment I knew I had the coolest wife on planet Earth.
Now, obviously... I do not know your wife as well as you do. I've been happy to have her on this show, but this is the moment that I thought your wife was the coolest person on Earth. She is in a new show about the glorious ladies of wrestling.
Glow. Yes, check it out. It's on Netflix.
On Netflix, and so she did get in, like, wrestling shape.
Yeah, no, she was in the best shape of her life. She wanted to be able to actually do all the wrestling moves, and while she was filming that, I was filming a movie where I was a heroin addict, and so I lost 20 pounds in 2 months. I think we might have a
picture. I got a photo, and this is the real deal.
Where I was at.
Not great.
Not great.
Yeah.
I didn't mess with her at the time.
Yeah.
couldn't really stand up for myself, but it was messed up. Like, I've never been the type of actor who comes home at the end of the day and is like, I can't get rid of the part. But when you lose that much weight, it affects you. And so, you know, I was full on depressed. And so I remember at one point, though, Allison, she called me out. She's like, you're not yourself. You're not fun to be around. And I'm like, I'm starving. What do you want from me? And then I'm like, I'm sorry. Don't hit me. Don't hit me.
Well, you look normal again.
So I feel normal. Yeah. Thank you. Yeah.